Thanks.
Circle round.
Isn't giving you the job. All right, give me a second. The broken clock tolls at midnight.
Which clock? This looks like the one.
Set it to midnight.
Well, just what the doctor ordered.
I came to Columbia because I believed in God and because I believed in honor. But Slade has shown me this. There is no God in shutting our brothers out from the family of man, and there is no honor in defending those who are strangers to its meaning. Perhaps in Finkton there is one more deserving of my service.
Some money. Here.
Can you get this open?
I haven't seen a lock like this. Anti-pressure device, a spring-loaded wiper, a relocker? You'd need a battery ram to open it. No machines. No tools.
Let's go find that gunsmith. Maybe he's upstairs now.
Booker, look. The shrine. It's a figure of Comstock now.
Mr. Lin? Chen Lin? Excuse me, Chen Lin?
Who are you? You speak up! Speak up! Can't hear you over all these machines! Very loud!
I'm Booker DeWitt.
Stand back! These machines very dangerous. Wait downstairs with Mrs. Lin.
Daisy Fitzroy sent us. We need to talk to you about getting some weapons.
Machines? Very dangerous. No place for stupid people. Want to lose pretty head?
Mr. Lin.
Downstairs.
What is wrong with him?
Remember him dead in that cell? Maybe in some way he remembers that too. How would you reconcile that?
I don't know.
My husband? Calm his troubled thoughts. Ease his burden. Bring Chen Lin back to me.
Excuse me, ma'am. I'm looking for Mrs. Lin.
Mrs. Lin?
No, I mean a little Chinese lady. She was...
Booker, this is Mrs. Lin.
They took Chen's tools. What's he got without his tools?
Well, your husband is a bit out of sorts.
If he could work again, maybe. If he could work, he'd...
Mrs. Lin, can you tell me who took your husband's tools?
Goddamn police. They took them and locked them up in the impound in Shantytown.
Sure. Would having his tools back fix his mind?
Who cares? We're not getting any guns if Chen Lin doesn't have his tools. Let's head to Shantytown.
Did you notice? Lin had a bloody nose.
Seems to be in style.
I'm not so sure it was a good idea.
Now, Jeremiah Fink has a philosophy. You see, your company is like Noah's Ark. You have the lions whose purpose is to keep order amongst the lesser creatures. Then you have the cow, the beasts of burden. Now, they provide meat, milk, and flavor. And then, well, there are the hyenas, the troublemakers, who serve to rile up the cow.
Go ahead. I'll be fine. Mystery to me as anyone else. Maybe Songbird knows, but he's not talking.
I'm sorry.
What for? I get to wear this stylish thimble to cover up my hideous deformity. I hear they're all the rage in Paris.
No, sir. I will not.
Do it.
Sure thing.
That way. Now!
Okay. Down here. You must think me some sort of freak. A girl who can bring dead men back to life. Whose only acquaintance is a giant bird creature. I must seem ridiculous.
You just got dealt a bad hand.
I am not going back to that tower, no matter what happens.
They won't stop until they have.
Why? What did I do to them?
You frightened them.
Good.
This is what they want from us. To keep you so hungry, you can't speak but your name. To keep you so ignorant, you can't think of solutions to all your problems. To keep you chasing that almighty silver eagle so you can buy everything they're selling to keep you down, brothers. But Daisy Fitzroy says there's another way. Another way coming real soon.
People are like this because of Fink. Maybe Daisy's right. Maybe she should pay him back for all of this.
Not before she pays us. We're here for guns and then the airship.
I guess we could head straight for the police station. Or see what's in that bar. What do you think?
Back it up, Skell.
Feel better already.
Stop him!
We'll string you up.
There's a tail.
Hurry
over there.
Hit it! Hit it harder! Hit it harder!
Barely making a goddamn dent.
I'm hungry, Bill.
Do it!
That.
Out of my way!
Thank you. guy there? A guitar. Wish I knew how to play. Might dispel some of the gloom.
A circle be unbroken by and by, by and by. Is a better home awaiting in the sky, in the sky.
When you force deep underground, well, you see things from the bottom up. And down at the bottom of the city, I saw a fire burning. The fire's got heat aplenty, but it ain't got no mouth. Daisy. Now she got herself a mouth big enough for all the fires in Columbia.
Thank you.
you unlock this?
Child's play. Done.
Thanks!
They argued something fierce at night, Lady Comstock and a prophet. Could never make out what it was about from my bunk, though. After the worst, I seen she ain't left for morning prayer. So I crept upstairs to check in on her. And like a fool, I lingered. Scullery maid was what they called me when I walked into Comstock House. Murderer was what they shouted when I ran out.
I see him!
Perfect.
There's the job, and there's life. They pay me to hate the goddamn Vox, and I take their money, but what's the harm of having a drink with Fitzroy's people? Face to face at the graveyard shift while they're just folk. Well, I guess I fell into the goddamn bottle because I stumbled back without the evidence locker key. If Schmidt finds out, well, there'll be hell to pay.
Fancy putting those lock-picking skills to work?
That won't take but a minute. Got it.
Now we just have to get them back to the Vox, and then we get our airship. It's locked.
Let me see. All done. Who are we really helping by getting guns for the Vox Populi?
It's gonna help us.
Daisy can make a change, can't she? Make things better for the people here.
Sure. we sure as hell aren't gonna be able to carry all this back to the shop. God, we didn't think this all the way through. What is that?
It looks like a tear. To another version of this room that doesn't have any tools in it.
Well, if the tools aren't in there, then...
Then they must be
back at the shop.
Booker, if we go into this tear, I don't think there's any turning back. Are you sure you want to go now?
Let's head back to the gunsmith and finish our deal. I aim to be on that airship and well shut up this place for long.
The Vox get their weapons. There's going to be a revolution just like Les Miserables. These people are gonna have better lives.
Yeah.
These people. Things can change, Booker, and we can be a part of it.
I don't want to be a part of it. Once we get our airship, we'll be well shut of this place.
Poster. In this world, you're a hero.
But the Vox, Slate, and I burned down the Hall of Heroes.
Okay. their nose.
Hard to think. Two memories in the same place.
Booker, come back to me. We're going to find Daisy Fitzroy.
And we're getting out of here on the first night. Let's go.
Delivering a tornado blow. Hold and release to build up a more devastating tornado blow.
Now!
All right!
Keep his head down! You can't!
more money. Take this. Well, I guess we did it. I don't know if I brought us to a world where the Vox had weapons, or I created one. Have happened.
Elizabeth.
They're dead, Cooper.
Come on. Let's leave this place. Let's go to the factory and get our airship. This isn't our responsibility. None of it. You just opened a door to this world and we stepped through.
Are you sure, Booker? Did I just bring us to a world where Chenlin was alive? Or did I create it? I told you, I always thought that my little trick was a form of wish fulfillment. Got my wish.
Looks like I got a friend in town after all. Slate. He's fell in with these Vox Populi. And for irregulars, I will say, they are loaded for bear. Problem is, I gotta help them with their damn revolution first. Then we take Comstock House by storm. I do that, I get the girl.
Great!
Go ahead.
Sure thing!
Can't get that door open unless someone takes that airship out.
Are we volunteering?
Thank you.
sabotage the engine and bring this thing down.
Okay, now to get off this thing.
Elizabeth,
let's go find Daisy in the factory.